Assalamu alaikum students. In the previous lectures, we introduced the concept of complex numbers. We learned how a complex number can be expressed as a sum of a real number and an imaginary number. And in today's lesson, we will proceed further into the study of complex numbers. So we will discuss the algebra of complex numbers. So we will see how the basic algebraic operations of addition, subtraction, multiplication and division can be applied to complex numbers. So first of all, we discuss equal complex numbers. When two complex numbers are equal. So equal complex numbers. So two complex numbers, let's say z1 equals to x1 plus I y1 and z2 equals to x2 plus I y2. So these are the two complex numbers. So if these two numbers are equal, then so if z1 is equal to z2, then this implies that x1 plus I y1 is equal to x2 plus I y2. So this implies that x1 is equal to x2 and y1 is equal to y2. So it means the real part of first complex number is equal to the real part of second complex number. So real part of z1 is equal to real part of z2 and imaginary part of z1 is equal to imaginary part of z2. For any two complex numbers to be equal, their real parts and imaginary parts should be equal. So it means, so real part of z1 is equal to real part of z2 and imaginary part of z1 is equal to imaginary part of z2. Now let's discuss how we can add two complex numbers. So now we learn how to add two complex numbers. So let's suppose we have two complex numbers. Z1 is 3 plus 4i and another complex number Z2 is 6 minus 8i. And we are going to add these two complex numbers. So we have to find Z1 plus Z2. So this means 3 plus 4i plus 6 minus 8i. So this addition can be easily done by just recollecting the like terms and then simplifying. So here we rearrange the like terms, like 3 plus 6 plus 4i minus 8i. So here we rearrange the like terms and then we simplify. So 3 plus 6 is 9 and 4i minus 8i is minus 4i. So this is the sum of these two complex numbers. So in order to add any two complex numbers, just collect their like terms or rearrange their like terms and then simplify. Now let's talk about multiplication of complex numbers. Now let's suppose we have two complex numbers. Z1 equals to 3 plus 4i and Z2 is equal to 6 minus 8i. So now we are going to multiply these two complex numbers. So we have to find the product Z1 times Z2 or 3 plus 4i times 6 minus 8i. So to multiply these two complex numbers here, we just expand these brackets and then we simplify. So on expanding the brackets, we get 3 times 6 minus 8i plus 4i times 6 minus 8i, so which is equal to 18 minus 24i plus 24i minus 32i square, which is equal to, so 18, now minus 24i plus 24i is 0, so 0 and 32i square. We know that I square is equal to negative 1, so it means 18 minus 32 into minus 1, which is equal to 18 plus 32, which is equal to 50. So 50 is the product of these two complex numbers. Now we will move on to the division of complex numbers. But before that, we are going to introduce a very important term here, which is called the conjugate of a complex number. So in general, we have a complex number z x plus I y, then its conjugate represented by z star is x minus I y. So the complex conjugate of a number is obtained by reversing the sign of the imaginary part of the number. For example, for the complex number 3 plus 4i, its conjugate will be z star, which is 3 minus 4i. Now let's learn to divide complex numbers. Suppose we have a complex number z1, 3 plus 4i, and the complex number z2, which is 6 minus 8i. So we have to find z1 over z2. So we have to divide z1 by z2. So we have to find the quotient z1 over z2. So that is 3 plus 4i over 6 minus 8i. So in order to perform this division, we will multiply this whole fraction by the conjugate of the complex number which appears in the denominator. So it means we will multiply and divide this fraction by 6 plus 8i. So what is the conjugate of 6 minus 8i? This is 6 plus 8i. So we will multiply this fraction, both numerator and denominator, by 6 plus 8i. So now we will multiply these two fractions and simplify. Now 3 plus 4i times 6 plus 8i divided by 6 minus 8i times 6 plus 8i. And if we multiply them, now we expand the brackets. So we get 3 times 6 plus 8i plus 4i times 6 plus 8i, and here in the denominator 6 times 6 plus 8i minus 8i times 6 plus 8i. Now we simplify further, so we get 18 plus 24i plus 24i plus 32i square, divided by 36 plus 48i minus 48i minus 64i square. So we get 18. Plus 24i plus 24i is 48i. 32i square. I square is minus 1, so it becomes minus 32 over 36, and this is 0, and minus 64i square, so which is equal to 18 minus 32 is minus 24 plus 48i over, so this is 36 minus 64 and this is minus 1. So 36 minus 64 into minus 1. So this thing becomes minus 24 plus 48i over 36 plus 64, which is 100. But we can also write it in standard form. So we can write it as minus 24 over 100 plus 48 over 100 i. So this is